Barclay Brown here at the INCOSE International Symposium 2022 in Detroit. So we're here on the exhibit floor talking to Tami Katz. Hi, Tami.
Hi there.
I wanted to ask you about certifications. So you're someone who's achieved two INCOSE certifications at different times, right? So going back, why did you choose to get certified in INCOSE? I mean, you could, but why did you choose to go through the effort to do it?
Well, it was a learning journey. I really wanted to do it to learn how to be a systems engineer. And once I got there, I thought I'd like to show that I know how to be a systems engineer. It's kind of a benchmark. And being able to have that CSEP and then eventually an ESEP really kind of shows the caliber of training I've had, the practice I do, and the continual improvement I seek.
So you used it as a way to sort of drive your own learning, right?
I've
got to pass this test, so I've got to study, and you learn more in the process like that. So it was a learning journey.
It really is. It's still a learning journey.
All right, very good. And so you, I think, are somewhat excited about certification, right? And are starting to bring it into your company somehow?
We are. We are CAB rep, and we do have a corporate advisory board membership. And with that, we've been kind of bringing INCOSE to a lot of our employees and encouraging them to seek out other opportunities like learning the material, learning the system engineering methods, and encouraging them to get certified so they can have the same learning journeys as well for their career.
So certification benefits the individual, right? Because it helps them in their career and it's a credential and so forth. But how does it benefit your company for people to go through this?
I think it's a standard practice. We're able to show that our system engineers really understand how to do system engineering, how to apply it, and we have essentially a kind of common bar we can measure folks against when they do show they have one of the SEPs.
All right. Well, that's great. So and where's it going? Let me back up and ask this. Do you have targets? Are you saying we want this many of our systems engineers to be certified or something like that?
I don't think we've quite got to the point of targets. Right now, it's more of an awareness and an encouragement, and then we've set up a path so that we can allow those who want to be certified the materials, the resources, the opportunity to take the tests. So we really enable it. So right now, it's more of an encouragement with a goal to eventually see, especially our system engineering leaders, certified.
It's important to try to make it easy. You know,
I
always say it takes two things to be certified, right? It takes being qualified, right? Mm-hmm. But then it takes doing the work to get the certification. And those are two different things, right?
They are.
So if you can make the work easier by things that you develop in the company, that can help.
And we like to show them their options. I mean, yes, there is a test to be an ASEP or a CSEP, but there's also the academic equivalency. And some of our engineers may choose to take some of those courses
and
take that route. And we like to be able to make sure that they know that's even a great option because you get an education as part of the process.
All right, terrific. Tami Katz, thank you for being here. If you want more information on certification, by the way, you can go to incosi.org/certification. Surprise, surprise. There you go. All right, so Barclay Brown here at the International Symposium 2022. We'll see you next time.